Hi, I'm Betty, and I'm here with my husband Rick, and we would like to welcome you to our Thanksgiving table this year. And I'm going to start right here at the head of the table and show you this place setting. And what we have here is a plate, and I have a bowl in it in case there is anything that this person wants to separate from what's on the plate. As far as drinks, we have coffee, which is made with a French press, and I have that in Betty's kitchen if you want to look up French press coffee. I've got a glass of water, ice water, and then of course I'm going to have iced tea, and I have a pitcher of iced tea at both ends of the table, so there will be no shortage, and there's more already made in the kitchen. Here we have butter for the whole table and more in the kitchen. This is a pat of butter that's already fixed for this individual, and this is the bread that we're using today. Right here is our tray of bread, and it is waffle biscuits. So they're very easy to make, and that's one theme that I tried to keep repeating in this series, is that most things on this table you can make very quickly and very easily. And there might be a couple of things that are a little more challenging that just gives you extra time to work on those, or you could just buy those if you wanted to. Okay, let's move on down to our appetizer. Here we have cranberry cocktail wieners. And I've put a couple out here just to show how you might want to serve them. You might want to put them like this and then have these cocktail picks and maybe some crackers to eat with them. And these are really salty and also tangy and great flavor because they have the cranberry flavor in there. I think you'll enjoy those. And if you would like to, you can leave them in a slow cooker and put it on keep warm and just bring it to the table with you if you have a place to keep it plugged in. Or just the crock itself, it keeps the heat in for quite some time. Now next on the table we have pecan sage cornbread dressing. And that's what it looks like, and it tastes delicious. I think you will love this recipe. I've done the same recipe for years, but I keep changing little things in it, and this time I put pecans in it. So you might enjoy that version. Here we have the perfect loaded baked potato. And it takes up a whole plate, but you can divide this among two or three people if you want to. I just made one, and that could be the whole meal for somebody, but it would be a very sweet meal. It's almost like a dessert. What I did with this potato is bake it, just as you might normally bake a sweet potato, and then scrunch it in a little bit. And then you can see my toppings are, this is coarse ground salt, and this is coarse ground peppercorns, black peppercorns. We have pats of butter. We have pumpkin pie spice. Here we have brown sugar. Here we have toasted coconut. We have toasted chopped pecans, and then we have miniature marshmallows. And there could be many other toppings if you want to just go away from this direction a little bit. You could have some peanut butter chips. You could have some butterscotch chips, things like that, because it's a very sweet type dish. But if you just stick with salt and pepper and have the baked sweet potato, it's a very healthy dish. Coming around the corner, we have ranch style whipped potatoes. You'll see that they have kind of a rusty color. That's because one of the ingredients that goes into the ranch sauce is paprika. So that changes the whole tone of the whipped potatoes. And the taste is very good. If you like ranch dressing, you'll love ranch style whipped potatoes. And then our entree is right here. It is a butter basted roast turkey. And it's the whole turkey where we have the breast meat and we have the drumsticks and thighs. The back is still there, it's not a prime part. But I do plan to make some kind of recipe that uses leftover turkey before too long. So it's kind of nice to have the pieces that people don't eat, which maybe would be around the back and so on. And around it, I have cranberries just because I wanted to put cranberries there and sage that came from our garden. So we're still getting a little bit of stuff from our herb garden. Rounding the corner, we have almost fat-free gravy. that goes with our turkey. So this is turkey gravy, and I used a fat separator in order to have it as fat-free as possible. And it is hot and yummy, and I think you'll enjoy it on those ranch-style mashed potatoes. Next, I have a dish that some of you will like. This is succotash, and I've decided to serve it in such a way that the most people will be happy. I've got just corn over here, whole kernel corn that I cooked in the microwave. I've got just baby lima beans here, and I cooked those in the microwave. So you could have one or the other, very healthy, and it doesn't really scream casserole. But if you like something like a casserole for your succotash, instead of just mixing those two together, here I have a cream cheese sauce for vegetables. So any vegetable that you cook, and you don't really have to cook it, you can make this cream cheese sauce. It's kind of like making a cheddar cheese sauce or any other kind of cheese sauce, but it's cream cheese and has that delightful, delicate flavor. It has some herbs in it too. And I think that's the end of our main plate. So we're coming to the desserts. Right here we have Sturminat bar cookies. And these are layered cookies. They have 6 layers. You just put them in a baking pan, one after the other, until you get the last layer in, and then you don't stir it. You put it in the oven and bake it, and then let it cool. It's ready to put into bar, so it's super easy. Another super easy dessert is right here. Here's an example piece of our impossible pumpkin pie. It's called impossible because it forms its own crust here. And it's not really a true crust, but it's an edge that is firm enough to stand up away from the filling, and you can call it a crust. And then our dessert that is the showpiece of the day is this one. This is a Lord Baltimore cake, and it has a delicate white cake inside. You can maybe see that here. It's just really light and airy and delicate. And then we have a layer in between the 2 layers of cake that is a filling. And that filling is just packed full of flavorful items, including candied cherries. That's why I put the cherries around the edge. But there's orange peel, there are nuts. There are lots of things that make it taste really good and festive, and I thought, what better time to make it than on a holiday table? So I chose Thanksgiving for the Lord Baltimore cake. So I think I have described everything that we have on our table. You will find a listing of all of these items, all of the names of the videos, and I will try to link them so that if there's one in particular you want to see, then go to the description box below and find the title that you want, and hopefully we can let you see what that recipe is. So I hope you enjoyed our table this year. We've enjoyed putting it together, as we always do, and I want to show my appreciation to all of you by giving back something because you have been really supportive of me over these past about 6 years almost. And I want to thank Rick, the cameraman. He puts up with a lot, and he's very patient and kind, and he does a good job. Thanks to all of you. Happy Thanksgiving.